It's Earth Day, and our theme is miracles. That's kind of an easy one, isn't it? So much about the Earth is a miracle. The fact that the Earth is here at all, that the Earth has a climate that allows human beings to live here, that we evolved in such a way that we get sun and water and soil to grow our food. We are part of the earth, we who are human. It's our home, it's our heritage. Earthling is an identity that we all share. And without that identity, none of the other identities would matter. The ecologist John Seed says, if you think that the environment is separate from you, try holding your breath and see how long you go without being part of that interdependent web, part of that connectivity that is Earth, of which we are a part. So when I think about miracles on Earth Day, that is where I start, from a profound sense of connection and gratitude. And after that, it's just a matter of where you can look that you don't see a miracle. So I made a list. I thought about all of the things that I personally encounter on this earth that feel like miracles to me. And it was hard to know where to start and where to stop. Because as I said, our mere existence is a miracle. And then when I start looking at all the ways that species have evolved to exist here, that also feels like a miracle. How amazing is it that a zebra, which in the zoo looks like this completely exotic, out-of-place children's drawing of stripes, evolves so that in its native habitat, it actually is camouflaged by the grass and blends in. How amazing is it that giraffes have long necks and that elephants can travel for hundreds of miles? All of the species on this earth have gifts, have adaptations that help them to survive. One of my favorite animals is the humble beaver. You know, they're annoying if you have a river or a creek that they've dammed up, but once I lived where there was one, I got really interested in watching them and learning about them. And I learned that they have little goggles that come down over their eyes to protect them from the wood chips that come up when they gnaw the trees down. Isn't that cool? They have built-in goggles. And so many species have something like that, something that they have particularly adapted so that they can do well, so that they can survive. I also think it's amazing the way that beings communicate with each other, with other species, with the land itself. Somehow beings make themselves known and identify themselves in all kinds of different ways. People like my associate minister, Lynn Unger, who communicate a lot with dogs, can tell you a lot about precisely how dogs do and don't communicate. But we have all of that work with chimpanzees and gorillas using sign language to talk about concepts that seem as abstract to us as death, but yet they're thinking about it. The more we learn about other species, the more amazing they are. The ways that they live together or don't. Some of the ways that they are to each other are horrible, just like the way that humans are to each other. And some of them are so nurturing and wonderful. And there's all kinds of things we can learn about gender from other animals, and rank and hierarchy and sociability. And we can learn from mammals and reptiles and fish and bugs, and so many species, if we have eyes to see, are offering us gifts. My brother-in-law studies ants. He studies specifically ants that grow fungus, that cooperatively harvest food for all of them. And he believes, actually with great sadness, that humans are missing a great deal by not learning from ants and modeling some of our behavior on that of ants. We as humans have this arrogance that we're the ones who can think and we're the ones who can know things. But the more you go into any other species, the more you see how miraculous they are and we are. As you know, I love plants, and there are so many miracles that I see in the garden. The most simple one being that a tiny seed can turn into a plant that grows many, many fruit, each of which is filled with more tiny seeds. The lesson of abundance that the earth offers if we are responsible and care for the earth. Another thing I love about the garden is that every spring, plants that look like they were dead turn out to still be alive. The perennials, they come back. I mean, in Minnesota, they really look dead. I mean, they are dead and buried for a number of months. If it doesn't snow, the ground just simply looks barren. But often, all you see is this stark white landscape for months at a time. And then, look at that! The flowers are back! The plants are back! How did they do that? Gordon Bach, who wrote the song Turning Towards the Morning, had this verse, which I just love. It's a pity we don't know what the little flowers know. They can't face the cold November. They can't face the wind and snow. They put their glories all behind them, bow their heads and let it go. But you know they'll be there shining in the morning. And that is another blessing and miracle of the earth, is that we know the seasons will turn. We know that day will turn to night, and winter will turn to spring, and spring will turn to summer, and summer will turn to fall. However that looks where we are, we know that that turning is happening. And look, doesn't it look like I'm just standing here? But really, just in the time that you come to worship and that I'm here, we are spinning around on this tiny blue planet. That's a miracle to me too. Why aren't we dizzy all the time? With both plants and animals, one of the miracles to me is how much beauty is figured into the earth. Why are sunrises and sunsets so beautiful? Why are there rainbows? Why do flowers grow in such an abundance of colors? And I know because as a kid, I would say to my physicist father, why are there rainbows? And then I would be like, wake me up when you're done explaining because I can't stand to hear another minute. So most of us don't know why, but we do know that things don't happen for no reason, that there is some reason why all of this color and all of this beauty is here. Some fundamentalists would say it was because God put it here. And that's one way to say it. But I think when we do respect science, even if we don't understand it fully, we can know that it's more beautiful and complicated than that, that it is a complex ecosystem where when we affect the balance of one thing, it touches things we can't even imagine. I wish that we kept that in mind more. It feels like often we do not. And so we don't respect the fact that we live in this miraculous place and that we owe gratitude and blessing, that is care and mutuality, back to this beautiful planet that we live on. Earth Day is a holiday not to mark the miracles as much as to mark the devastation. But as we do, I think staying rooted in what we love gives us strength to do that. This life is a miracle. This planet of ours, it's a miracle. Every sunrise is a miracle. The fact that I'm talking to you and you're listening and we're together is a miracle. Happy Earth Day. May you find ways to protect and cherish this planet of ours, and may you also find ways to receive the blessings of the earth and to share them with others.